situation that our country is faced today, whether you look at agriculture, whether you look at real estate, whether you look at manufacturing, all along the line there is downturn in the economy. And if this situation is not reversed, the worst thing would happen on the employment situation. If income growth slows down month after month, quarter after quarter, the scope for creating more jobs for our young people is going to be very seriously affected. I mentioned that the growth rate has declined for 5 successive quarters and now it stands at 5%. The Congress Party, I had issued a statement summing up what's going wrong, and I can only repeat those things, that agriculture is the cornerstone of economic activity in our country. 60% of our people live in agriculture and allied activity areas. And the latest figures of the growth rate of agriculture is 2.7%, as against previous year of over 3.5%. And the dangerous point is that the real wage rate in the agricultural sector, in rural sectors, have been static for the last 5 years of the BJP government. And this is no surprise then that the demand for manufactured goods is going down, and the manufacturing sector, the latest quarter figure which are available is 0.6%. The manufacturing industries are being affected for want of demand, for want of investment incentives, and the result is that there is today an all-round atmosphere of gloom and doom. Real estate is one activity which affects millions and millions of our people, and I have the figures of real estate housing situation in the first half of 2019. There are in 8 major metropolitan centers 4.5 lakh dwelling units which are lying vacant, and there is no demand for those units. And if real estate is affected, construction activity is affected, employment in the construction activities is affected, and that's what is happening in our economy, which is there for all persons to see and objectively. The rupee is getting weaker and weaker, and one could take advantage of that weakness of the rupee to push up exports, but exports in the last 5 years of BJP government rule have been sluggish, have been more or less stagnant, and the result is that the balance of payment situation is getting worse and worse. In addition, there is today an atmosphere that investment is not picking up. The automobile industry is crying for aid, crying for help from the government, and the general feeling in the industry is that if the present trend of auto sales is not reversed, there will be at least 1 million people who would face the prospect of unemployment. Therefore, the atmosphere today is in the country as a whole is one of doom and and bloom. One could hope that the BJP government would come up with a package to stimulate demand, to promote investment, but you talk to anybody in industry today, the general feeling is that there is tax terrorism in place of incentivizing investment, and that's the reason why private sector investment is sluggish, and there are no signs that private sector investment will pick up. The stock markets are showing the signs of reacting to this atmosphere of doom and gloom. So therefore, overall situation in the country is one of, as I said, protracted down, slow down. Our responsibility as a Congress party is to go to the country and to tell them that the promises that were made by the BJP government during the Lok Sabha election, they are now being ignored, and in fact the economic reality of the country is very different from the promises and the targets that were set by the BJP government. Prime Minister himself has been talking about $5 trillion economy to be achieved by 2024. Now this looks like a pipe dream. In 2018-19, the economy was of the size of $2.7 trillion, and if we have to reach $5 trillion economy by 2024, we need a growth rate of 12% per annum in nominal term, 9% in real term, and if the economy is going down the way it has been going down from quarter after quarter, then there is no hope that the Prime Minister's promise of a 5 trillion economy will become a reality. It is our responsibility and it is our duty to take all this message to the country and to point out how the BJP has misled the country, and what is now being done is only cosmetic to push up the atmosphere, but working on the situation in the country is such that it is quite obvious that what was promised is not being delivered, and there is no sign that the government is thinking of the real plan of action to incentivize the economy. With these words, I once again thank Congress President for giving me the opportunity to speak to this August audience.